Hello, I'm Ty Mason from the diabetescouncil.com, a researcher, writer, and I have type 2 diabetes. Today, I'm going to answer the question, is tequila good for diabetes? But before we get into that, make sure you download my free diabetes management book, which also includes a diabetes grocery shopping guide, foods to eat and avoid, by clicking the link below. Now, I know some of you are just wanting me to skip all the research stuff and get straight to the answer of this question, but be patient. You need to understand why I'm going to give you the answer to this question that I do. And let me say at the onset, before getting this question, I really knew nothing about tequila other than it was a hard alcoholic beverage, and it was a pretty cool song by the Champs by that name. Recently, a few articles popped up in newspapers and magazines stating that researchers have found that tequila helps lower blood glucose. They were pointing to a study by Dr. Mercedes G. López, a researcher at the Centro de Investigación y de Estudios Avanzados in Guanajuato, Mexico. Now, the 2014 study discussed the effect of a natural sweetener from the guava plant to aid in weight loss and reduce blood glucose levels. Known as agavins, the plant-based sweeteners slow the stomach from emptying, which boosts insulin production. They're also non-digestible, which means they act as a dietary fiber but can't elevate a person's blood sugar. Now, we have found, said López, that agavins reduce glucose levels and increase GLP-1. They also increase the amount of insulin. Now, GLP-1 is a hormone that slows the stomach from emptying, thereby stimulating the production of insulin. She added, agavins are not expensive, and they have no known side effects except for those few people who cannot tolerate them. So why did I spend this time talking about the guava plant and agavins? Well, some of you probably know this, but tequila is made from the guava plant. And the assumption that many made were, since agavins are so good for those with diabetes and tequila is made from the same plant, then tequila must be good for diabetes. Hold on, though. López went on to explain that agavins are the only carbohydrates used to produce tequila. All ethanol in tequila comes from the fermentation of the glucose and fructose generated after the agave pines have been cooked. But because the agavins are converted to ethanol, agavins are not found in the finished product. So tequila has none of the product found to lower blood glucose level or stimulate weight loss. So, is tequila good for diabetes? Well, the answer is no. In fact, because the body treats alcohol like a drug, the liver spends so much of its time trying to break it down, it does a very poor job in helping to regulate low blood glucose. Now, I'm not saying those with diabetes can't drink tequila or any other alcohol. I'm just saying, if you have read claims that tequila helps lower your blood sugar, those claims are absolutely false. I hope this answered your question, is tequila good or bad for diabetes? Don't forget to get your diabetes management book by clicking the link in the description box below. And as always, let me know if you have any other diabetes-related questions. Thank you. I'm Ty Mason.